I'm Sir Tap Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Dr. Robotnik's Egg Venture 2. No, I'm pretty sure that's the name of the game, guys. So yeah. We're gonna see something a little special here. So,
file select.
It's just, I love that Sonic Adventure 2 gives you a warning when you open a file. It's like, are you sure you want to open a file? It's like, wow. That's just how edgy this game is. Like, even opening a file is pretty dangerous. Select. So we're just gonna play some normal City Escape here. Just some- oh fuck, that's too normal, hold on. I needed this to be slightly more normal, Sonic.
Stage select.
There we go, that is the correct color of normalness. We're gonna see some normals at City Escape. Oh yes. So you might have seen my video of, it was, Pumpkin Hill, the classic. So, there's a mod. It's actually from Debug Code. It's not even, like, a real, like, mod sort of thing. You can do this in the GameCube version of the game, too. I'm not sure about the Dreamcast one. It might still have the code in it. Basically, there's just a mod that lets you access a bunch of debug features, one of which is any character in any stage, which happens to include Dr. Robotnik from the, Chowstouches. You know, Ronald Reagan once said, the seven scariest words in the English language are, "Hi, I'm Omochow, and I'm here to help you." Dr. Robotnik has some limitations in this game. Ah. He actually cannot break these crates normally. So, our buddy Omochow is going to help us out there. There's also going to be several stages I can't complete. I was initially hoping to play the whole, like, the story mode with Dr. Robotnik playing all the levels. I can't do that because all of the boss stages and some of the other, like, mini-game stages and stuff just straight-up crash, and certain levels are impossible. In fact, I know it's a bit further now, but this level, actually, unless there's some weird clip that people know how to do, is impossible. I love his attack animation. So, if you're not familiar with Sonic Adventure 2, and shame on you, by the way, for that, if so... Dr. Robotnik is supposed to have this big mech that he plays in, but they made an out-of-mech version for him in Chao Garden. It's not supposed to be in any of the levels, but, you know, Dr. Robotnik doesn't care about stupid things like that. He's still ridiculously fast. He can still do loop-de-loops. He can still attack enemies. He just has to get really close. Like... I'm actually not sure if I can get past this one, due to it being in the air. There's also a super speed code and a moon jump code. I put those in for convenience. Certain areas are going to be impossible because Robotnik does not operate certain objects. As you can see, he does not grind on rails at all. He cannot jump up, like there's pulleys that Sonic can grab on and they raise him up. We're gonna need Moon Jump to get up those. Fortunately, we can run up walls. Spring pads. I'm so glad springs work. I wish he was just a little bit more functional, because there's a few things that will crash, and there's certain levels that are impossible, and certain levels... Oh man, this is good. This is the best. Oh yeah. This is what Sonic Adventure 2... Oh! Yeah! It's gonna crash a few times. I'm not sure how many stages I'll actually play, but that's good. I planned something else because I knew the game was gonna crash. So welcome to my current wallpaper. Hello, Bandicam recording thing. Red Lego Waffle drew this. It's a drawing of her and an actual photo of me. So let me show you. Oh, right. Just to not rip off the joke, the Dr. Robotnik Egg Venture 2 joke was actually from a person named Zebra on YouTube. Let me show you the mod program I'm actually using. This is all very easy to do, because like I said, it's actually just debug code stuff. So all you need is, you need this character select mod, and then there's also some debug codes in here. I just tossed in... Stage select, have all stages in stage select since I have played Sonic Adventure 2 to completion over 3 times, but not on PC, so I don't have, you know, a complete save file. Super jump, you actually want, because that's the moon jump, you know, you just hold A and you just fly. That's actually pretty important because we, you know, Robotnik has vertical challenge issues. And have all upgrades I just threw in there for fun, so I can just play any level without issues. But that's pretty much all you need. You just need this character select mod. I'll have a link in the description to what you can do to this. And the nice thing about this mod, once you have this save, you know, you go in here to save this, you can actually launch Sonic Adventure 2 from Steam. Like, I'm just launching it from Steam now. And full screen that. And we're still going to have that mod active, and we're going to be able to be Dr. Robotnik. So like I said, I'm not sure how many levels we're going to play this way. Some of them are not going to work at all. But that warning gets me every time. All right.
Stage select.
So we were basically done with City Escape. There's a low cliff sort of thing that we can't get to, so we can't actually finish. Oops. City Escape. The way you activate this code is you hold X. Come on. Well, you hold a button to select a character. X happens to be what mechless Dr. Robotnik is. We can be Dr. Robotnik in a mech, which would let us get through more levels without issue. But, oops. Where's the fun in that? Sorry, Robotnik. Anyone distressed that I am calling him Dr. Robotnik can get out right now. Dr. Robotnik is the superior name, and I will hear no arguments to the contrary. Also, fun fact, I was never quite good enough to unlock this stage back when I played this on the Dreamcast, and I never really bothered when replaying it. So this is the first time I've actually played the stage, and I am so glad to be able to enjoy it in the proper manner that we are enjoying it now. I'm so glad that some of his quotes are intact. Several are not. For instance, he makes weird noises. It actually seems to be based on the stage, what weird noise he makes. He has issues around ledges sometimes. This level is also made for Sonic. As you can see, Robotnik has some issues. Oof.
Yes, Parky.
We're playing Dr. Robotnik Egg Venture 2, Parky. Oh man, I didn't miss the loop-de-loop, did I? Oh, what did that happen to here? Yes! Yes! Oh god, yes! This is the best thing I've ever seen. Oh man. There's gotta be a loop, right? I know there's a loop in this level. No! There was a loop. I must have skipped past it. Whatever. We did see a loop in the first in City Escape, so that's fine, I guess. Do we get the Robotnik clear quote? Now the game's confused. We also don't get any Yoshis. That's unfortunate. Surprisingly, you can complete certain Knuckles levels. I'm pretty sure Pumpkin Hill, the best level objectively in the entire universe, is not completable because I think it always forces you to have one thing that you have to dig up, and Robotnik cannot dig. I really wish, you know, I would seriously do a full Let's Play of this game like this if somebody modded it so that Robotnik was, like, viable and, like, could complete all levels. Oh, this again. So we'll need help from Omachow to get into there, but that's fine. Omachow is very useful and helpful. Come here. See, don't let anybody tell you that Omachow is a worthless piece of garbage, because he's not. You can use him to break crates as Dr. Robotnik. Damn it! No, get back here! Get! Hold on. Oh, if you're unaware, the PC port of Sonic Adventure 2 is pretty decent. Yes! Thank you, Omachow. You've hopefully noticed this is slightly better than 480p. The camera that sonic effect, sound effect. The camera controls are still a little weird. You know, they're not real proper 3D camera controls. But I think this one must be under us. But graphically, things look, you know, like they should. A lot of stuff in the original game is, you know, like the 2D stuff, you know, they didn't redraw everything, which I wouldn't have expected them to. Let's get some hints. We have six pillars. Okay. Is it up here? A dark place. Oh. I don't see it. Where is it? I have no idea what I'm missing here. I haven't played this in so long. I'm sure I used to remember the actual locations of all of this crap, but not now. I was hoping we could just complete one of these real quick. We can't operate that, of course, either. Where is it? I hear you. Oh my gosh, where is it? I'm so close, but I can't see it. Is it inside this? I can't. I think it's inside that, and I can't get it. Oh well. Stage select. Most people don't like the Knuckles levels anyway. But we have to see. There's something in Pumpkin Hill that we have to see. Well, there's actually a few things in Pumpkin Hill. Aside from the amazing music. Let's get that Shovel Claw! These appropriate sound effects that play too. Unfortunately, we cannot use the tombstone by some grass. Yeah, as you can see, the sound effects are different per level. It's like, I think since Robotnik, I have to see that again. I just adore how he clings to rockets. Like, so good. If you don't love Pumpkin Hill, you're not welcome to watch my videos. I'm sorry. You have to stop. And let me just say that I, non-ironically, but also some parts ironically, but generally, I non-ironically enjoy Sonic Adventure 2. I think it's a really great game. It's definitely a product of its time. It definitely makes some mistakes, but God damn. And no matter how cheesy the damn music is, it's damn good. Like, even the ridiculous cheesy rap from Sonic's Knuckles levels. Here we go. I just want to get one emerald from here. Because I think the last one always spawns in a diggable place. So I'm pretty sure we can't complete this level. Or if we can, it's like all RNG, and I mean, I don't care that much. Oh, don't tell me it's inside this guy, because I can't kill him. Oh, there it is! Nope! Robotnik, please. This is why we have the hover. Oh! That knockback! That's OP. He has problems around corners. I'm not sure what that's about. Oh yes, the crotch rocket! Oh man. Oh, and he got a little- he died on the rocket. I'm not really sure what happened there. Calm down, Robotnik. Also, I love seeing him get blown up. I think there's supposed to be wind for Knuckles that does that. So good. The majesty of Robotnik's flying. It's just one more time. Just one more time. Yeah, it's good. Alright. Rest in peace, Larry. A ghost got him. Let's see what Pyramid Cave is like. I'm enjoying this far more than I should. How long have the video got here? We're at about 15 minutes. I love this. I haven't played every level yet, I'm not sure how many levels I'm going to play. I might call it a video after this one, and I'll let people know, or let me know if you want me to continue or how many levels I should do. Like, I can't actually complete the whole game. There's some stuff. There's actually some stuff in this level I'll have to avoid really. Oh. Yeah, here's the thing where he doesn't attach to that. So that's one of many reasons I actually need to have that moon jump on. Yeah, here's something I have to avoid. Those will crash the game. Actually, we saw that in City Escape, didn't we? It crashes the game if I touch those. Also, Robotnik's jump isn't intended to be, usable. So, certain stuff just isn't possible. I do love that his running speed and, he's based off of Sonic's code, I guess. Oh, yes, yes, yes! The bounce bracelet, yes! This is the greatest day of my life. The sound's still going. Ahem. Alright. Without the bounce bracelet, we'd be stuck here too. Also, there's certain stuff where you have to, shut up, Omachow. Shut up, I hate you. Come here. Come here, Omachow. Omachow. I want to kick you. Whatever. Robotnik's attack is hilariously difficult to use. It's only meant to abuse Chows. Which is a feature of this game, by the way. If you didn't know, to get a Dark Side Chow, I believe you have to, hit them and stuff, which is slightly cruel. Oh, man. Actually, I don't think you can attach to those, so that's fine. Does he attach to... Oop! Oh. Yeah, those ghosts grab onto you, but the animation doesn't play. Did he Yosh? He did something. If you didn't know, in Sonic Adventure 2, because it's a very high-quality game, a whole bunch of Japanese voice quotes were left in the, characters' normal lines. So, Knuckles goes, O-do-do-da! Like, he's some frickin', Fist of the North Star character. Dr. Buttnick goes, Yosh! I can't really think of many others. There's a couple other lines of Robotnik's that seem to be Japanese, and Knuckles, too. I don't think any of the other characters got the same treatment. Yeah, I don't know, but Robotnik's Yosh is pretty famous. I am so glad that this is preserved, that he, is able to run through these Sonic-only things. It's so good. Oh, God. Oh, man, we made it! We made it! So yeah, there's even a code to shrink yourself, but it doesn't shrink your hitbox, so you can't get under those things. I do not believe there's any way for Robotnik to get through the roll, things. Uh-oh. There's my glorious work. Robotnik tagged up all over it, this pyramid. I think this is kind of a stretch. But I'm starting to think Robotnik might have some, narcissism issues. I don't know. Just thinking out loud here. While I obviously have to do cheats to get this, I adore how playable this is. Look at this. This is so good. Look. It's just prone, T-pose. Mid-air animation. So good. If there are any mods that make this even more playable, excuse me, that was A-rank material. Ahem. If there's any mods that make this even more playable, please do let me know. I don't really have time to do mods. I have a bunch of written reviews I need to get to, but if I could mod one thing, I would mod playable Robotnik for all of these levels. He would dig with his beard and get, frickin' all of his Knuckles levels crap. And then he would, just throw, baby animals and be able to break shit in... Let's play one of Tails' levels. Normal. Mech Robotnik would actually be able to play this level normally. But Robotnik has minor difficulties. Like, let's try to... Yes! Robotnik's kick has, like, a hilariously tiny hitbox. I don't think it goes up, either. It's like, it's only to hit Chao's, like I said earlier. I love the surf rock for, you know, dangerous city full of robots shooting at me. It's very fitting and relaxing. Oops. One of the many cheats, there's also a... oh, yes! Oh, fuck. I'm kind of surprised the others didn't crash, honestly. Yeah, this is why I'm not going to try to do a full playthrough. I literally can't. The game just crashes a lot. Any boss stage will crash. Any mini... Like, and I don't know... I could theoretically play only the levels with Robotnik, but then I would have to know what's coming up, which I don't. Like, I don't know the exact order. Let's pick one more level to look at. Which one of Rouge's levels would be possible? Or what's something... What's something that's fun? Actually, let's take a look at Shadow's level. Actually, I think Shadow's levels are probably pretty bad for this, since Robotnik can't do rails. At least if I recall correctly, Shadow does lots of rail levels. Though Sonic has the most rail level. One of the space ones. I'll never get tired of watching him do the run through the loop. And I love his legs! Look at the legs! It's so good. I'm so glad this game exists. Our lives would be so much poorer without this game. This is the art that Sonic Adventure 2 has been waiting for. This is how it's meant to be played. I can't. Come here, Omachao. I'm going to help you. No! Omachao! Bye. I just had to do that. Unfortunately, I can't hurt Omachao because I have to get so close that, damn it, that my grab overrides my kick. I love how effective Robotnik is in combat. It's so good. Some wonderful baked lighting there. Oh, oh, oh! Yes! Is he being hurt by the rocket? Why did I get hurt there? I don't think it should be necessary to play like this, but there is an invincibility code if you want that in that mod launcher that I showed you earlier that's required to show this. I also love that they had to edit out all of the soap ads. This game had huge product placement for soap shoes, which are like... I guess they're like supposed to do the actual grinding crap that the game shows. Can I? Let's go. I figured not. Let's go! Oh, they just search as random... like sound files to get his things. We can't break crates. We saw that earlier, I guess. Like, I'm 99% certain that used to say soap, but now it just says speed. It's kind of funny. I think some Virtual Console releases actually got edited because they had to remove ads. And they put in, you know, fake video game ads. Oop. The rocket hurts him! Why does the rocket hurt him? Oh my god. Why does the rocket... Oh, hey. Oh! These wonderful Gen... what? 5? 6? Yeah, Gen 6 physics. I guess maybe that invincibility code is kind of relevant. If he takes damage from rockets, like, what's going on there? Whatever. That's part of why, Got Ring? Oh my god. Camera, please. I'm too fast. Yes! I'll never get tired of that. I'm so sad he doesn't do tricks. When you jump with... Aw, Crash. When you jump with decent timing on those, you're supposed to do tricks, but obviously Robotnik does not have tricks. Oh, well. That's enough for one showing. But yeah, if you want to see more of Robotnik's magical egg venture, I guess leave a comment. I can play the other levels. I mean, I can't beat the whole game or anything. I can't do the boss rush because the game crashes, but there's like at least... There's a bunch of other levels I could try. I have no idea which I can complete quite yet. Usually the Sonic levels are kind of playable, but and you just have to hover through a bunch of stuff sometimes. But yeah, that is Robotnik's Egg Venture. I thought I would try something a little stupid here to break up more serious Let's Plays. I just love this actual photo of me. This is pretty much just a mirror image of me right now.